In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of posterior part of knee. I'm going to focus on muscles and important place. Why am I talking about backside of knee? Personally, I believe these muscles are very important for knee pain and knee stabilization. So here I am, I will explain that. First of all, these guys are hamstrings. This one is biceps femoris. This is lateral part of knee. Lateral. This part is medial. And this one is semimembranosus. Membranosus. This one is semitendinosus. This one. These three muscles together, this is hamstrings, okay? When hamstrings get tight, that can inhibit hip movement. You know, tightness of this place can induce tight pelvis and tight posterior part of leg, right? But think about it. Hamstrings cross knee. That means when this muscle gets tight, that also can affect knee movement, knee stabilization. And this tightness can create pain around here, right? Because when muscle affects joint, that can create pain, correct? That is why hamstrings is very important for posterior part of knee, knee pain, knee stabilization, not only for knee movement. Oh, by the way, what is function of hamstrings for knee? That is knee flexion. Just, you know, for your information. Let me move to next muscle. You see this? This is one of calf muscle. This is gastrocnemius. Gastrocnemius. This muscle is very famous for ankle movement. That is plantar flexion, point out toe movement, right? Gastrocnemius is mainly for ankle movement. Wait a minute, but gastrocnemius attaches to femur, right? It attaches to femur. That means this muscle also crosses knee, and it's very close to knee joint, joint capsule. So when this muscle gets tight, that also can affect knee mechanics, knee flexibility, and knee pain. See, hamstrings and gastrocnemius are very important for posterior part of knee. Not only for knee movement, for knee pain and knee stabilization. These two muscles are very important in my opinion. Okay, now let me move to important landmark. You see this? These are nerves. By the way, this is hamstrings, this is gastrocnemius. There is nerve in midline of knee. This nerve is tibial nerve. Tibial nerve. You see tibial nerve here. By the way, there is no big muscle on midline of knee. You know, hamstrings are here. Gastrocnemius is here. What are they? What kind of muscle is there? Nothing. So this is very, very fragile place. There is skin at the most superficial part. Deep to skin, there is fat, adipose tissue. Now deep to that, there is tibial nerve. So there is no big muscle to protect tibial nerve, this area. So this is very fragile place. So when you got trauma here, that can directly affect tibial nerve. What happens when nerve got trauma? That can lead to pain or numbness. You know, this area, midline of posterior part of knee, is freaking important. Why? Because no big muscles cover this area. That is why I focus on posterior part of knee very much. Of course, anterior part, middle part, and lateral part are equally important, but I want you to emphasize how posterior part is also important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.